Okay. Hello to all the new interns. This is the assignment brief for your first assignment at Involved Innovations. So before we begin, you know, with the internship itself, I would like you to know two major factors which you have to be careful about throughout your internship tenure. The first one is the concept of plagiarism, and the second one is the concept of content spin. Now, what is plagiarism? Now, while we write content, while we write creative content, the aspect of copy-pasting is followed by a lot of different people. Okay. But when it comes to professional content writing, we as individual writers, we have to make sure that we do not copy-paste anything from anywhere, be it definitions or quotes or whatever be the case. We are not going to copy-paste anything from any particular source. Now, we are all intelligent people and we are educated enough to read a particular paragraph or say an article and then analyze it and interpret it in our own manner. So that is what we are primarily going to do in specific cases. Let's say even if you're not familiar with a topic, let's say machine learning or something of that sort, what we are going to do is we are going to watch maybe certain videos about it to get particular idea on machine learning or artificial intelligence, and based on that we are going to write, compose content. Okay, at no point in time do I want anyone to copy paste content from any source. Another thing which new writers also do is that maybe they read a sentence and they in fact just change the meaning of a few words, maybe, you know, just use synonyms and then represent that particular sentence in their own way, and they say that, yeah, this is my own sentence and I haven't copy-pasted anything. That would not work. We want authentic content which is generated straight from your mind. So please be careful at all times not to copy-paste anything, because plagiarism is a big issue in our industry. I want to make it clear from day one itself that plagiarism, and I'm coming to the concept of content spinning, these two things are unethical and should be avoided at all times. So how do we avoid plagiarism? The first and the most basic thing which I do, which still works for me, is that it's simple. I read a paragraph and then I represent it in my own words. Let's take for example a sentence of my name is Elvis John. Okay, this is a sentence, my name is Elvis John. So I can reframe this and use it in a different way and, you know, compose something different out of it. Let's say I go by the name of Elvis John. Okay, you see, it's different from my name is Elvis John. Okay, so that is what we are looking for. So whatever you read or whatever you write, it should not be in correlation to your reference link from wherever you're taking assistance or information from. I hope this point is very, very clear, and I hope it's not followed by anyone in terms of plagiarism, copy-pasting thing. Okay, so I hope no one does that. Instead, we are looking for authentic 100% original content, and we do have tools which detect plagiarism. So if at all plagiarism is found, those files are going to go straight back to you. So you will be the one who will be fixing the files. So it will be additional work for your end in itself. Okay, so we understand that you guys are students and you have limited time, you have to study as well. So from your end, try to be as transparent and true to your profession as much as possible. Theek hai? And provide authentic content so that rework, the concept of rework, is eliminated, because I don't want to send back the work which you have done. So it becomes double, you require double the effort to complete a particular assignment. So plagiarism is to be avoided at all times. Now coming to the concept of content spinning. Now we have a lot of clients who want us to write on a particular subject and they want numerous articles on it. Let's say digital marketing. Okay, our topic is digital marketing and the client wants 20 odd articles out of it. So what our responsibility is that we provide 20 different articles to the client, not just the same article and we spin it again and again and give it to the client, right? So that is what content spinning is. Maybe today if you're writing an article on digital marketing, okay, let's say advantages of digital marketing today, tomorrow again you have a similar assignment which you have to cater to digital marketing as well. What we are going to do is write on a different aspect of digital marketing. Let's say the relevance and the popularity, the increase in the popularity of digital marketing. So we are going to try and make sure that we do not repeat our own content. Okay, that is content spinning, where you keep on repeating your own content and spin it in a specific way, so that basically you're repeating the same thing but nothing is fresh. So that is what we have to avoid. Plagiarism and content spinning has to be avoided at all times. So these are the two fundamental things which you guys have to, you know, pay attention to at all times, no matter what the assignment is. This has to be followed always. Golden rules of content writing is to avoid plagiarism and content spinning. If you can avoid that, if you're smart enough to write with your own language, with your own words, then it's amazing. Okay, I hope these concepts are clear. Now we will move on to the concept of keywords. Okay, now keywords are an essential, you know, element to content writing as well. Okay, now what are keywords? So let's just go to Google and search. So let's say I want to purchase a new phone, right? Mobile phone. So most of the common people, what they would do, they would go on Google and type out something which would help them to find out about a particular mobile brand or a mobile phone, right? So I'm going to do the same thing here as well. Let's just type in mobile phone online on here. Okay, so in this search bar of Google, what you type becomes the keyword. Okay, becomes the keyword, automatic keyword to your relevant search. Now what Google does is links this keyword, whatever you have typed in, to all the websites which also have the relevant keyword. If you check, Flipkart has mobile phone as the keyword which has been highlighted here, then followed by Snapdeal also mobile phones out, highlighted out here. So no matter what you type in, okay, these are other related keywords to what I have typed in. Okay, so these are suggested keywords as well. So what you type in on Google becomes your keyword. So when it comes to client companies which we are working with, they are going to give us keywords based on which we are going to write articles. So what's the function of this keyword? We are going to use that particular keyword in our article, so that whenever, you know, a person searches any product or anything related to that particular keyword, what Google will do is link the keyword which the audience they are typing in with your article, which will also have the keyword, and that is how they come across the website of the client. You know, that is how the final customer gets in touch with the people who are trying to manufacture specific goods and services. All right, through this article keyword linking. All right, so that is what primarily we are going to do in this first assignment. I hope the concept of keyword and plagiarism and content spinning, they are clear. Now we will move on to the assignment brief of this of today. Okay, now you will see the subject line of the assignment. It is mentioned out here, word count mentioned in the spreadsheet. First, there are different word counts provided to every individual intern, new intern. So then followed by a unique code in the bracket, which is SES0050. This is the client code which we are working with. So we have X number of clients, and to make things easier, which client is processing which job, so we have segregated them into different project codes, so that we understand that this project code or this mail belongs to this client. So today we are going to be working with a client, SVS. Okay, and the project number is 50. So SVS0050 will be your project code. We are going to use this project code to rename the files. Okay, I will come to that point later. 26th April is your deadline date. Now why do we make the allocation at around evening for the interns to process? We understand that you guys are attending colleges or involved in other activities in the morning, most of y'all. Okay, so there's no point in assigning you work in the morning, because most of the work is not finished by the morning itself. So what we do is make the allocation later towards the day, so that evening may or during the night you guys can sit for a couple hours, complete your work and make the submission. So this is what we do. So your deadline is 26th April, so try to get your work done by the evening in itself. If not, then the next day morning, try to have this completed by 10 a.m. So that what I do is, I come to the office and then I check my mails, whatever assignment I have received. So I start downloading the files at around 10 a.m. So if you can complete your work by the evening or the next day morning, 10 a.m. in itself, then that would be fantastic. That should be your target, to complete your assignment on a daily basis. Alright? Now moving on to the assignment, the core instructions of the assignment itself. We are going to process 4 different types of content in this assignment: articles, blogs, press releases and company profiles. Okay, some of you are writing articles, some of you are writing blogs, some of y'all are writing press releases, and some of y'all are writing company profile. Okay, so now we have to understand how to write different types of content. So this is the best possible assignment for you guys as beginners, because you will be writing all different major 4 different types of content which is involved in the content writing industry. Okay, now moving on to the general instructions provided here. Client company website mentioned in the spreadsheet. Okay, articles and blogs should not be promotional. The client company's name should not feature along with any competitor's name. Another very important thing in SEO content writing is that we indirectly promote the company, the client company, without taking the client company's name. Okay, now how do we do that? Let's say for example Amul. Okay, Amul is our client, and what is Amul involved in? What are they manufacturing? Basically dairy products, right? Milk, chocolate, then yogurt, ice creams and all of that. Okay, so this is the general service or products Amul is providing. Now how do we write non-promotional content and also promote the services of the client without taking the name of the client in itself? It's very simple. We are going to write titles such as advantages of purchasing ice cream during the summers. Let's say health benefits you will receive by consuming a glass of milk every day. So what we are doing is highlighting the positive bits, like health benefits of milk when you have it on a daily basis. Okay, so you're highlighting what will happen to your health if you have a milk on a daily basis. Indirectly you're promoting the services of the client, but we do not mention the name of the client. Okay, so this is what you have to do for articles and blogs. Your keywords have been given to you. What you have to do is compose general, very general titles, and then create content in that way. Okay, now on the other hand, company profile and press releases have to be about the company. Alright, now company profile in particular is nothing but very similar to a Wikipedia page. It's a very informative page where you have to talk about this, when was the company launched, who are the people responsible behind the company, the management team, then how many employees are there in the company, what is the main operations of the company, the services they offer, the products they sell, all of that. And press release, on the other hand, is you have to imagine as if you are, let's say, a news reporter, okay, and you are covering the activities of a company, and you have to write an article based on it. So press release is going to be something of that sort, where you cover, let's say, again taking the example of Amul, you can maybe say write about how Amul has become the leading dairy product manufacturer in India. So as a reporter, stepping into the shoes of a reporter, you will say that Amul has done so and so, it has this amount of employees, and they are planning to venture out into the new markets, not only in terms of the Indian market, but also global. Then positive feedbacks about their products, alright, like that. So you have to process press release in that sort of a format. Okay, if there is any confusion, bullet points have been highlighted here in terms of who's writing what. So article, if you are getting confused how to write an article, you can see that the article needs to be informative, should not be promotional, should have formal language, avoid first person reference. Articles are like that. Then again for blogs, again references have been provided. Company profile, it's been given out here, how to process a company profile. And similarly, press release has also been given. Okay, so these bullet points will help you out when it comes to writing your specific allocation. Now, it comes to renaming of the files. Okay, files are to be saved as, number one, project code, group, and the type of article you are writing. Okay, I will come to that later on. Please make sure to provide fresh content in every file, especially when working with the same keywords. Yes, okay. Be sure to compose different titles. Okay, okay. Now moving on to the attached files provided here. These are the four files which are going to act as your sample. So the person who is writing article, you can refer to this file and check out what sort of tone is being adopted, what is the quality of the content, how is the keyword being used, all of this. Okay. Similarly for blog as well, a sample blog has been attached here. You see how we normally process blogs, a very informal tone of writing, a very friendly way of writing, you know, where you engage the, you know, the attention, you try to grab the attention of the reader of the blog. Okay. So blogs generally have a very catchy titles. Are you looking for so and so? Something of that sort. Okay. So that's how we write blogs. On the other hand, articles are very informative. So it'll be like straight up, the titles are going to be very hard hitting. Alright, something of that sort. On the other hand, company profiles do not generally need a title. A generic title of company profile, their client name has to come. For this company profile, Genic Students, this is another client of ours. We have added their company name in the title in itself, and you can just check out how the company profile has been formulated here, followed by finally the press release. Okay, this is how a press release is supposed to be written. If you see, the keywords have been highlighted in bold. Okay, that is what you guys are supposed to do. Alright, now moving on to the allocation sheet. Okay, I think I have allocated the wrong sheet out here. One second. Just give me a second, guys. Okay. 36. Okay. So this is going to be the allocation sheet for you guys. Okay. If you see, let's take the example of Disha. Disha is working with group 23. Her client name is Advance. Her keywords are provided. She's writing a blog, and the blog has to be of 300 words. So one file of 300 words. So that is why it is denoted as 1 into 300. A minimum of 300 words is required from Disha. Her deadline is 26th April. Similarly with Akash. Akash is doing group number 23. His client website has been provided, Advance. He's writing a company profile. His allocation word count is 1 into 300. Again, he's writing 300 words, and his deadline is 26th April. So the keywords listed here, so they have to be used in your article at least once, both of them. So skill development loan, skill loan companies in India. Okay. These have to be used at least once in your article, blog, CV, whatever you're writing with respect to whatever has been assigned. Now there are certain keywords. Let's, if we just scroll down a bit. There are certain keywords like top fintech companies in India. Okay. Now this doesn't mean that you give me a list of the top fintech companies in India. I do not want that. What you have to do is compose a very general article which is based on the services of the client. And when it comes to including the keyword in your article, you will just do it very generically. Let's say, for example, top fintech companies in India provide such and such premium services to their clients. Okay, but your article has to be related to the services of the company. Again, I repeat myself, if your keywords are top, let's say XYZ company in India, or the top 10 best financial firms in India, that does not mean you give me a list of the financial firms. No, these are just merely keywords which you have to insert in your article. Your article has to be completely general, or your PR has to be about the company which you're writing about. It's just that you have to fit your keyword in a specific way in a sentence organically. That's it. That is the only use of the keyword. Apart from that, you will not, you know, base your article on keywords alone. Okay, you just have to organically use the keywords inside your blog, article, CP and PR. Okay, I hope I'm making myself clear. In case if there is any confusion, please feel free to give me a text or give me a call straight away. Alright, if you see some writers are working with articles, like Harshita is working with an article, Parishi is working with a PR, Ishika is working with an article. So if there is any confusion based on that, please give me a call and we will have a discussion on this. Alright, now for the people who are working with AdWords, okay, let's just see how many of you all are there. Okay, so there are quite a few people who are working with AdWords apart from Harshit, Parishi, Ishika and Janvi. All of y'all are working with AdWords. So the people who are working with AdWords, I just want y'all to know that AdWords is a very unique financial company. Okay, what they do is they specialize in providing in skill development loans. Okay, not conventional loans. Let's say, for example, I want to pursue a course on diploma course on hair cutting. Okay, I want to be a hair stylist. But to be enrolled in a course, it's pretty expensive. If you just find out that what is a particular amount is to be paid for a hair cutting course or say catering course, it's pretty high. It crosses more than lakh or 2 lakh or something of that sort. And it's a long tenure, 6-7 odd months you require to complete that course. So regular banks, what they do is they do not consider these type of loans as educational loans. But they are in fact educational loans, but banks do not recognize them as educational loans. So what AdWords does is they specialize in providing loans for skill development, which will help you to gain certain experience in a particular field, be it animation or catering or let's say web designing or say auditing or let's say creative such as hair styling, makeup. Okay, AdWords does this. So I want your blogs, articles and PR to focus on this aspect a little bit. Okay, so if you require more information, you can go to the client website and see what their services are, what specific services they are providing, and based on that you have to provide content. Okay, again, for the guys who are writing blogs and articles, please make sure not to use the name of the client company anywhere or the competitor. What you have to do, the client website is provided only for you guys to understand what services they are providing. Again, going back to the example of Amul, if I am working with Amul, they are offering dairy products. So in my article, in my blog, what I will do is promote what is the benefit of using their products rather than taking the company's name. Okay, I hope I'm making myself clear. In case of any doubt, again, please give me a text or give me a call. One more thing is that there are a few people who still have not texted me. Those who haven't texted me yet, I think Siddharth Saxena, that name comes in mind, and another new intern who has not texted me on WhatsApp, please do text me on WhatsApp because I communicate primarily through there. Okay, and we will be dividing this big team of interns into two different teams. Some are going to stick with me, some are going to be reporting under a new head. Okay, so we will do the division soon, but for now you guys are going to report to me. And yes, file submission. So try to get this done by the evening itself, if not then tomorrow morning. Rename the files again, I'm saying. Please work on Google Doc, either on Google Doc or Microsoft Word. Make sure that there's no plagiarism. Rename your files with the project code SVR0050, which is going to be same for everyone. Then group XYZ, I mentioned here, but if you see, as per your allocation, I'm opening the wrong spreadsheet again. As per your allocation, if Akash is doing group 23, so automatically he has to fill that up, the group space, with group 23. Okay, yes, it's 0050, group 23. Type of content, either you're writing a blog or a company profile or a CP or a PR, you have to fill that up. Okay, so that is how you rename the files. And after doing all of that, please reply back to the same mail chain. Okay, just write out here, project completed, attach the file and send it on the same mail chain in itself. If you guys know how to use Grammarly, I would recommend that you please run a grammar check and always make sure to proofread your files before making the submission. Okay, there are a few other things which I would like you guys to know, and I would be mailing you the standards of Inault Innovation, a new email about the company itself, about the writing format, because we write normally in Calibri and justified line alignment. So I hope you guys get through that, and if at all there is any confusion regarding anything, please feel free to give me a text. This video will be uploaded on YouTube and it will be shared with you very soon. So please go through this, and if there is any doubt, again I say, please give me a call straight away. That's it for now.